Hello children, how are you all? I hope you are all better. Now we'll learn a new lesson in this video, unit number 4, science in everyday life. In this lesson we'll learn about scientists from Tamil Nadu, Sir C.V. Raman, and about Dr. A.P.J. Abdul Kalam, and we'll understand the reason for the blue appearance of the sky. And we'll learn about reversible and irreversible processes in our daily life. And we'll discuss about waste generated in our environment and proper disposals of waste and some ways to reduce the waste. Come, let's start the lesson. Scientists from Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu has a long history of science since ancient times. Many of the concepts were reflected in Tamil literatures. Tamil Nadu has produced many scientists' contribution to the world of science. Let us discuss about the few scientists and the department and their contribution. Dr. M.S. Swaminathan in the department genetics contributed green revolution. Srinivasa Ramanujam in the department of maths and contributed composite numbers. Venkatraman Radhakrishnan in the department of biology contributed structure of ribosome. Dr. A.P.J. Abdul Kalam in the department of aeronautical engineering contributed missile development. Sir C.V. Raman in the department of physics and contributed scattering of light. First, we'll learn about Sir C.V. Raman. He was born in the year 1888. Chandrasekara Venkatraman was born at Tiruchirappalli, Tamil Nadu on 7th November 1888. In 1904, he completed his Bachelor degree of Arts at the Presidency College, Chennai. He also completed his Master of Science degree from the University of Madras. He stood first and won gold medal in physics. Sir C.V. Raman won the Nobel Prize in Physics in the year 1930 for this work, Scattering of Light. He was also awarded Bharat Ratna in the year 1954. Next, we'll learn about the blue appearance of the sky. One day in 1921, Sir C.V. Raman was sailing in the ship in Mediterranean Sea. He observed the blue color of the sky and started reasoning it. He finally concluded that the sunlight is scattered by the gas and particles present in the air. White light we see is composed of different colors such as WebGR. What is WebGR? Violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. Among these colors, blue is scattered more. Because of this reason, sky appears blue most of the time. During sunrise and sunset, rays have to travel long distance. Since they travel long distance, all other colors except red are scattered. So sky appears red at sunrise and sunset. Every year, February 28th is celebrated as National Science Day in order to show respect to the invention of Raman effect by Sir Chandrasekara Venkatraman on the same day in the year 1928. Next, we'll learn about an aeronautical scientist named Awul Pakir Jainulabdin Abdul Kalam. He was born on 15th October 1931 in Rameshwaram, Tamil Nadu. He completed his Bachelor of Science degree at St. Joseph College, Tiruchirappalli in 1954. Later, in 1960, he got his degree in Aeronautical Engineering from Madras Institute of Technology. Abdul Kalam is known as Missile Man of India since he was involved in the India's Missile Development Program. He also served as a President of India from the year 2002 to 2007. And he is referred as People's President. He was awarded Padma Bhushan in the year 1981, Padma Vibhushan in the year 1990, and Bharat Ratna in the year 1997. He has written many books like Wings of Fire, India 2020 and Ignited Minds. Next, we'll learn about changes around us. Change is the transition of a substance from one form to another form. We see many changes around us, right? Yes, day and night it changes, summer, weather, season it changes. And also we see changes in objects, right? Can you name any examples for changes in objects? Yes, growth of a tree, fruits ripen, falling of leaves, etc. These are the changes happens around us. Have you ever observed any changes in you, children? Yes, your height and weight increases, right? Your hair and nails also grows, right? Yes, these are the changes. Now, we'll learn about the changes around us. Changes around us is divided into two types, reversible changes and irreversible changes. First, we'll learn about reversible changes. Changes which can be reversed are called reversible changes. For example, if you keep a water in a freezer for some time, what happens? It is transformed into ice. And if you again take that ice and keep it in the room temperature, what will happen? The again ice will be converted back to water. This is called reversible change. Water is converted into ice and ice is again converted into water. This is called reversible change. Now we'll learn about irreversible changes. Changes which cannot be reversed are called irreversible changes. Example, if you burn a piece of paper and it burns and turns into ashes, can we get the paper again? No, once it is burnt, we cannot get it back. This is called irreversible change. Now, we'll learn the difference between reversible change and irreversible change. Reversible change. A substance can turn to its original state. The chemical properties of the substance do not change. Most of the physical changes are reversible. Irreversible change. A substance cannot change to its original state. The chemical properties of the substance will change. All chemical changes are irreversible. Next, we'll learn about waste generated in our environment. Waste is any substance which is discarded after primary use. It is worthless, defective, and of no use. They are unwanted and undesirable materials. Children, you all have seen waste, right? Waste is divided into two types, namely household waste and waste from school. Now, we'll learn about household waste. Waste from home is known as household waste. Solid waste disposed from home and apartments comprises of garbage and rubbish. Can you name any waste from the house? Yes, bottles, cans, clothings, compost, disposable items, food packings, newspaper, magazines and trimming. We further classify the household waste into five types, namely organic waste, toxic waste, recyclable waste, solid waste and e-waste. We'll learn about them one by one. Organic waste. Organic wastes are kitchen wastes such as vegetables, flowers, leaves, fruits. They are, when they buried under the soil, they converted into organic waste. Next, we'll learn about toxic waste. Old medicines, paints, chemicals, bulbs, spray cans, fertilizers, pesticides, containers, batteries, shoe polish. These are called as toxic waste. They are not suitable for our environment. Next, we'll learn about recyclable waste. What are the recyclable waste? Can you say an example? Yes, papers, books, these are all recyclable waste. Yes, glass, metals, plastics, these are also referred as recyclable waste. Next, we'll learn about solid waste. Cloth soiled with blood and other body fluids are called solid waste. Next, we'll learn about e-waste. Computer parts, electronic materials, cell phone parts, and CFL bulbs or e-waste. Do you know, children, 40 million tons of electronic waste is generated every year. These e-waste comprises 70% of our overall toxic waste. E-waste contains hundreds of substances, of which many are toxic. Children, next we'll learn about waste from school. You leave many waste materials inside your classroom and throw away many things in your school campus, right? Yes, in our school, we collect them and dispose them properly. For example, if they are not collected and disposed properly, like papers, pens, chocolate covers, plastic items, it will pollute the school environment. The most common material which is generated in school is food waste. Food is not only wasted, but it is also thrown out everywhere and making surroundings unclean. A survey conducted found that food waste accounts 23.9% of the total waste generated in school. The papers like cardboard, white paper, mixed papers with 23.5% of the total waste. We need to keep our surroundings clean, so we need to have a proper waste disposal system. Next, we'll learn about need for proper disposal of waste. We found waste lying everywhere. Children, what do you think we should do? Yes, we need to have a proper waste management system. This waste management system is needed to control pollutions like water pollution, air pollution, and soil pollution. So we need waste management system to control all these pollutions. We need waste management system to conserve natural resources like forests, minerals, and waters. Waste disposal affect the environment badly. We also need waste management system to control the spread of diseases. Nowadays, there are many infectious diseases spread due to pollution. We need to dispose our waste properly to control all these diseases. We also need a waste management system for recycling for further use. Waste can be recycled to get products for further use. The last topic we will discuss about ways to reduce waste. The best place to start changes is from our home. We need to learn how to reduce, reuse and recycle the waste. We should use reusable and recyclable bags and containers. Avoid one-time use items, and we should use items which are used permanently. We should segregate waste into biodegradable waste and non-biodegradable waste and hand over to the municipal people. We should not throw the waste here and there. We should dispose them properly. We should not waste food. Organic waste can be converted into manures. These are the practices which will be helpful to reduce waste in our home and school environment. Children, we'll watch a video now.
Irreversible changes. Having studied about reversible changes, let us perform similar activities to learn about irreversible changes. Take the same balloon that we used to perform the reversible activity and blow it to its full size. Tie its mouth tightly with a string. Now prick the balloon with a pin. Oh no! The balloon bursts with a loud noise. Now what do we see? We see that the balloon has changed its shape and size, and it cannot regain its original look. It means that this change cannot be reversed. Such a change is called an irreversible change. Thus, an irreversible change is a permanent change that cannot be undone or reversed. Let us perform the second activity. Take a piece of paper and draw an aeroplane on it. Now cut along its outline. On doing so, we get two pieces of paper, that is, one is the picture of the aeroplane, and the other is the remaining paper. This means we do not get back the original piece of paper. Let us now perform the last activity. Take some dough and make a ball. Roll out a roti. Bake it on a tawa. Oh, the roti is ready. As in the reversible activity, can we get back the ball of dough from the roti? No, it's impossible. From the changes that occurred in these activities, we can conclude that the change in which new substances are formed and we cannot get back the original material is called an irreversible change.
Students, I hope you all enjoyed the video and understood the lesson. We'll see the reading part in the next video. Thank you, children.